Rise up on our feet now. Let's close our eyes to sing this song loud and clear.
Holy Spirit, be my comforter.
complete, complete in Him. I'm complete in Him. Complete, complete, complete in Him. Hallelujah. I am complete. Sing it loud and clear.
Complete, complete, complete in Him.
Hallelujah.
I am complete in Him.
My grace alone
is not my works of righteousness, but my grace alone is not my works of righteousness, but my grace alone. Oh, I am complete.
Oh, yes, complete.
Complete, complete, complete.
Hallelujah.
I am complete. Complete.
Oh, yes,
complete.
Oh, yes,
complete.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you for a time like this. And we thank you for the mightiness of your name and your power. We thank you because your word says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him from them all. He keepeth all his bones, and none of his bones is broken. Father, we give you praise. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. This morning, as many of your children as are gathered into this service, let there be no one who will go home with a plastic experience. Touch your people. Minister to your people. I take authority over every power assigned to derail and to torment. And I bind and cast them out in the name of Jesus. And it is well with you. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Louder, amen. Let's have a seat. God bless you. This morning, we're going to focus our message and our prayers on what I call destroying mountains. The mountains that destroy. How to destroy them. Destroying mountains. Destroying mountains. Listen very carefully. So that when the time comes, you know how to address your own issues. Let me say straight away that we're not here this morning to play. We're here for very serious assignment. So anybody who is not expecting very much to happen should not bother to pray. We'll read four scriptures very quickly. The first one is in the book of Zechariah. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 7. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 7. He says this, "Who art thou, O great mountain? Before Zerubbabel, thou shalt become a plain, and shalt bring forth the headstone thereof with shoutings, crying, grace, grace unto it." I read it again and make it personal to myself. And I think you should make it personal to yourself too. "Who art thou, O great mountain? Before Daniel Olukoya, thou shalt become a plain." Can you read it again and make it personal? Two issues are identified. There was a great mountain. There was a fellow called Zerubbabel. The mountain was disturbing Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel did not sit down to chat with the mountain. He addressed it. Spoke to the mountain directly. In the book of Mark chapter 11. Mark chapter 11. I read from 22. Mark chapter 11 from verse 22. Mark 11, 22. "And Jesus answered and said unto them, Have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, Be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith." Keep that too at the back of your mind. Whosoever shall say unto this mountain, who will talk to the mountain? You have to talk to it. Not talk to God now. You're talking to that mountain. I know that somebody here this morning, the first prayer you are going to pray against your mountain this morning shall bring chaos to the camp of your enemy. If you are that person, let your amen be loud and clear. In the book of Matthew chapter 17, Matthew chapter 17, I read from verse 14. Matthew 17 from 14. "And when they were come to the multitude, there came to him a certain man kneeling down to him and saying, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he's a lunatic and self-vexed. For oftentimes he falleth into the fire and oft into the water. And I brought him to thy disciples, and they could not cure him." It was a mountain. Then Jesus answered and said, "O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer? Bring him hither to me." And Jesus rebuked the devil, and it departed out of him, and the child was cured from that very hour. Then came the disciples to Jesus apart and said, why could we not cast him out? And Jesus said unto them, because of your unbelief. For verily I say unto you, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say unto this mountain. That problem they just brought to them, it was a mountain, this mountain. Remove hence to yonder place, and it shall remove, and nothing shall be impossible unto you. I'll be this kind goeth not out, but by prayer and fasting. Some mountains will not move until you join fasting to your prayer. In Jeremiah now, Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 25. Jeremiah 51, 25. Our major scripture for this month. Jeremiah 51, 25. Say, behold, I am against thee, O destroying mountain, saith the Lord, which destroyed all the earth, and I will stretch out my hand upon thee, and roll thee down from the rocks, and I will make thee a burnt mountain. There is a power that can set mountains ablaze. And that kind of mountain is what the Bible calls destroying mountain. Life battles are very real. Life battles can be very, very rough. Life battles can be very rugged. Life battles can be very unpredictable. And whoever you are, wherever you are coming from, whatever background you are from, you cannot escape the battles of life. Life battles respect nobody's status. They attack both the rich and the poor, the literate and the illiterate, the handsome, the ugly, attacks everyone. But there is a specific department in life's battle called mountains. Mountains symbolizes difficulties of life. Mountains represent the immovable and the impossible. Mountains represent situations too steep to climb. Situations too high to cross. Situations too awesome to see beyond it. That's what we mean by mountains. Mountains are life challenges that are so high, so hard, so tough to subdue. That's mountain. Mountains are burning and boiling life problems. Mountains are problems that are too hot to handle. Mountains are problems that are too hard to quench. Mountains are life difficulties that are constantly defying human intervention. Terrible situations. A woman dragged her daughter for prayers and said, man of God, pray for this, my daughter. She has had 13 broken engagements. 13 times men have come to the house to say, I want to marry her. And after the engagement, they break off. Nobody could understand what's going on. The other time a woman came. She had 4 children. 4 women, 3 men. 4 women, 3 men. 7 children. All ranging from the age of 49 downwards. No one was married. None. Those are the mountains. Mountains. What do we mean by mountains? We mean situations and conditions that are beyond human strength. That are beyond human solution. What are mountains? They represent thorns in our lives that restrains us. What are mountains? They are problems that waste our desperate labor and effort. Somebody will work hard, the enemy comes to waste it. What are mountains? There are situations beyond human strength and human wisdom. What are mountains? They are the wealth-consuming problems. A person gets some big money. Immediately the big money comes in, big problems moves in. And the problem will swallow the money, until that money has finished. No, that money is coming. If you are like that here this morning, Allah is a wealth-consuming enemy, mountain facing you. Those mountains shall be scattered in the name of Jesus. What are mountains? they are faith-shaking situations, faith-shattering situations. Water mountains, they are progress-hindering troubles. Water mountains, they are destiny-hurting problems. Water mountains, they are heart-breaking problems. Life-bending, life-caging problems. Water mountains, they are life-bending, tension and tear-generating situations. I pray for somebody this morning. By the time we close this service, those silent tears you have been shedding shall turn to testimonies. If you are the person, let your amen be loud and clear. Water mountains, they are agents of affliction and restriction and demotion. While I was still working as a scientist, there was an Ethiopian man, very intelligent lecturer, brilliant man. If he talks, you say, this man is 4 times professor. At any scientific conference we go to, when this Ethiopian man stands to talk, there was no time he stood to talk and they didn't clap for him after he had finished. Both white and black. But he had a mountain. Brilliant, but tied down. Something happened to him which made me cry. Me. It wasn't me it happened to. It was him. I cried for him. In an interesting way, he discovered a particular chemical. If you apply that chemical to your yam and you plant the yam, by the time the yam grows, a single person cannot approach it. It will be large. If you put that chemical in a fish farm, the fish becomes unusually large. If you put this in any plant, the plant becomes big. He discovered that chemical in Nigeria here. So he didn't want any of his colleagues to know about it. He didn't talk to anybody about it. He was going into his laboratory every night to work on it. He works in the night because he doesn't want anybody to know. Eventually, he got the research to a level where it can be published in an international paper. But before he could publish it, he wanted the professor who trained him to just look at the paper. Sent it to this white man professor abroad. For 6 months, he didn't hear anything again. One day he traveled abroad. He decided to check on this professor. Immediately he entered the professor's laboratory. And he saw the giant tomatoes the man was growing. He knew that the professor had stolen his research. He was very angry. He rushed to the man's office. Said, I asked you to help me to read the paper. Now you have stolen everything. Now I can see the large tomato. What are you doing? With what chemical are you doing it? And there was a lot of noise. The white man said, no, this is what you found, and what I found is similar to yours, but it's not the same thing. That was how this man lost the research. A mountain was before him, telling him, you will not be great, neither will you excel. He eventually left this country as a poverty-ridden lecturer. I'm praying for somebody here. At every mountain of thou shall not be great. Every mountain of thou shall not excel. By the time we close from this service this morning, they shall be scattered to desolation. They shall be scattered. 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 In the name of Jesus. What are mountains? Mountains are obstacles or difficulties. Water mountains, they are giant enemies. Giant enemies. Water mountains, they're incurable infirmities. Insurmountable life circumstances. Painful disappointments. Situations that turns expectation to disappointment. Those are the mountains. Anything that turns a source of joy to a source of sorrow is a mountain. All the disfiguring and defiling problems, they are mountains. The unexplainable hard labor, they are mountains. All the strange demonic possessions, they are mountains. A lady did the first surgery. They forgot cotton wool in her womb. They had to do another surgery to remove the cotton wool. They did the second surgery. They forgot the needle inside her. Mountain. There's something that's against her life. Something that has been tormenting her destiny. Mountain. A woman was in her sitting room, and a strange woman walked in. And when the strange man walked in, greeted madam, said, "Madam, how are you?" Turned to her husband, said, "Darling, we are going out. Go and pack your things." In the full glare of the family in the sitting room, the wife was looking at the husband to see what the response of the man would be. But to her amazement, the husband jumped up and went to the room to carry his briefcase and his coat. Meanwhile, the strange man was whistling in the sitting room, Then the man came out. And the strange man turned to Madame again, said, "Madam, I want to borrow your husband for 2 weeks. He will come back after 2 weeks, don't worry." I said, "Bye." And the husband followed her. The woman told me that she felt like going to the kitchen, taking a bottle, breaking the head of the strange woman. But something restrained her. That a person who was bold enough to walk here like that and order your husband out, you think he's an ordinary woman. So you better go and pray. Oh, was brought her to the mountain of fire. Before that time, she was praying ice cream prayers. "Father, let your power envelop your daughter and deliver her from the powers of the night. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, is now, and forever shall be. World without end. Amen." Those were our prayers before. Those prayers are good, but they are useless when a destroying mountain is facing you. I'm praying for somebody here. Every mountain that wants to destroy you shall be destroyed. They shall be destroyed. They shall be destroyed. They shall be destroyed. In the name of Jesus. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to suck people dry. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to make people to live in reproach. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to kill hope. They are killers of hope. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to crush destinies. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to waste health and waste wealth. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to disfigure people's destiny, to torment and to terminate. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to heat and boil people's destiny. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to extinguish glory and beauty. The agenda of the destroying mountain is to rob people of their peace and their rest. Jesus, our master, taught us what to do when we are facing mountains. He made himself very, very clear that when a mountain is facing you, you need to do something serious. When there's a mountain facing your way, and the mountain is trying to attack your destiny, there are four things you can do. When there's a mountain facing you, four things can happen. One, you can stand by that destroying mountain and cry, and weep, and complain, and grumble.
Are you blocking my way?
You can stand at the foot of the mountain and cry till day break. It will not move the mountain. You can do that one. That's an approach. But the approach will do nothing. If when David got to the war front that day and he was seeing Goliath at the front,
"Brother Goliath, please, now why are you harassing people here? Don't do this now. Don't be a naughty boy. Don't do this kind of thing."
Goliath will waste him. Two, you may decide to want to climb it, but it may be impossible or difficult to do. And the person may even die in the process. Many people have died climbing mountains physically. Three, you may decide to dig a hole through it to pass to the other side. That too may be impossible or difficult, and it could sap away the whole of your energy. Four, you may decide to use the method taught by the Lord Jesus Christ. You speak to the mountain and command it to move. You pronounce the curse of God upon the mountain and you command it to move. You stand by the mountain and you decree with a voice that is as loud as thunder, say, "Woe unto you, mountain, blocking my way." Jesus taught us to speak woe unto unprofitable things blocking our ways. In Mark chapter 11, from verse 12. And on the morrow, when they were come from Bethany, he was hungry. And seeing a fig tree afar off having leaves, he came, if haply he might find anything thereon. And when he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for the time of fig was not yet. And Jesus answered and said unto it, Jesus spoke to the fig tree, no man eat fruit of thee hereafter forever. Forever. Then what happened? Verse 20. And in the morning, as they passed by, they saw the fig tree dried up from the roots. And Peter, calling to remembrance, said unto him, Master, behold, the fig tree which thou, what did he do? Curses. Or he said, which thou blessed. He cast, is withered away. Jesus now said, have faith in God. Was then he said, you can do similar thing to the mountain. Is there any destroying mountain facing you? Pronounce the curse of God upon it. Pronounce the curse of God against it. Speak woe unto that mountain. Speak woe unto any destroying mountain facing you. When we say woe, we mean grievous distress. We mean affliction. We mean trouble. Wretchedness, misfortune, calamity, disorder, catastrophe, when you're talking about woe. There'll be somebody here this morning, you will speak woe to your mountains, and the mountains shall be destroyed. When we say woe, we mean bad news, disaster. And so you see Jesus in the Bible say, woe unto the scribes, woe unto the Pharisees, woe unto this, woe unto that. All those places, Jesus said, woe, woe, woe unto. Go and check the place up now. When you speak woe unto destroying mountains, they will become the enemies of themselves. When you say woe unto the mountains will begin to oppose themselves. When you say woe unto the mountains, the Pharaoh fighting you will sink in their own Red Sea. When you say woe unto the mountains, you invite constant sorrow upon that mountain. As many people as are here this morning, I want to speak woe to your mountains. What is the way? Number one, you must surrender your life to Jesus in order to address any destroying mountain. Two, you have to repent from every known sin in order to destroy any destroying mountain. Because if you address the mountain and say, mountain go, mountain go, mountain go, the mountain will want to know the reason why they have to leave. Remember the story in the Bible. The sons of Sceva, they went to a demonically possessed person. Say, in the name of Jesus, whom Paul preached, depart. And the demon said, ha, look at this one. Say, Jesus, I know. Paul, I know now. Who are you? They had no power to address that mountain. Because there are issues in their lives to resolve. When you tell a demon, I bind you, I cast you out in the name of Jesus, and the demon tells you to shut up, there are issues in your life. Then three, the third thing, pray inquiry prayers to locate your mountain. Locate the mountains. Pray inquiry prayers. And four, speak woe unto the mountain. Put the curse of God upon that mountain. Say, if any of you shall say unto the mountain, be thou removed, and then be cast into the sea, and you will not doubt, say, it shall be so. And finally, barricade your life against destroying mountains. There are times to do praise worship. There are times to talk to the Lord. There are times to address the enemy. Read your Bible well. Understand these principles. When Jesus got to the tomb of Lazarus, he first of all spoke to his father quietly. Father, I thank you because you always hear me. Not the people that are here. Let them know that you sent me. Thank you, Father. Now it now turned to the enemy now, to the mountain. The Bible says he raised up his voice and cried, Lazarus, come forth. He wasn't talking to God again at that level. He had gone to another level. You speak to the mountain. Ignorance of these things can lead to a serious disaster. Ignorance is a disaster indeed. I read a story that a woman was flying to Abuja. She's an illiterate. She didn't go to school. A very aggressive woman. So she entered the plane. She bought economy ticket. And so that's why she sat. But immediately the plane took off. She stood up from her economy seat at the back and went and sat in the first class seat at the front. The air hostess told her, "Say, madam, you are not supposed to be here. You pay for economy. Go to the back." She said, "No, Laila, I've paid to enter the plane and I can sit anywhere that is convenient and comfortable for me." So the air hostess went and reported to the junior pilot. The junior pilot came and said, "Madam, you can't stay here. You didn't pay for this place. Go to the back." Said, "No, get away from my front." They now went to tell the senior pilot. I said, "Senior pilot, there's one illiterate woman there in the first class. Who doesn't want to go?" "Oh," the senior pilot said, "no problem. My wife is an illiterate. I know how to deal with them." So the senior pilot just went to this woman and whispered something in her ears. Quickly, the woman ran away from the seat and ran to the back where she came from. Everybody was surprised. "Sir, how were you able to move away from her?" "Sir, I just told her that, where are you going?" I said, "Abuja." I said, "These people sitting at the front, if any good, they will drop them." Amen. And she quickly ran to her seat. Ignorance. Anyway, rise up on your feet. All eyes closed. In case you are here this morning and you are not born again, it is impossible to destroy any destroying mountain if you are not a friend of God. Just raise up your right hand where you are and say what I'm going to say after me. Say, "Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you now. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from today, I say bye-bye to the devil. In Jesus' name, amen." If you say that short prayer with me, immediately we close, just find a way to the altar here. All eyes closed. Please, we're not here to joke. We're here for serious business. The first prayer I want you to pray, it will do an uprooting agenda. There are people in the meeting here this morning. The problem you are facing is because there is a satanic tree growing in your body. You can't see it, but it's growing there. The enemy can see it, and they are using it to harass you. Immediately we start this first prayer, you may feel dizzy, you may feel uncomfortable. Don't be tired. Just keep saying it. Keep saying it. There are people here today, the problem they are facing is because at one time or the other, the enemy cut off your ear and used it as a destroying mountain to be fighting you now. The destroying mountain facing some people here is due to the evil dedication your parents dedicated you when you were young. Immediately we begin to pray now. These three situations will be addressed. You will shout this loud and clear. And it's important that you talk. You don't keep quiet. This is not a keeping quiet service. You have to address mountains. You talk to the mountain, not God, not your friend, the mountain now. You do it after the order of Jesus, who cried out at the tomb of Lazarus. Shout this loud and clear. Destroy mountain! Assign against my life. Woe unto you! In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and declare. Speak war unto the mountains. Open your mouth, open your mouth, open your mouth. Badaka sente la kaya bo shente la basanta. Bakatende ribo sapone kaya ba. Aha, aha. Enough is enough. In Jesus' name we pray. I told you. Yes.
giant enemies. I convert you by fire to become ant enemies. Aha. And when it's an ant, what do you do to them? Sisters, can you call the prayer and let me hear you? What did I say? Sister, say it again. Brothers, can I hear you say this? Everybody together now. In the name of Jesus, convert them to ants. Patasata lakaya boshandaraba. Deal with them. That's why you are here this morning. Aha, aha. In Jesus' name we pray. The next prayer will usher many, many people here into the kind of breakthroughs that will seem to them like a dream. Provided you pray this prayer with boiling aggression. Dark mountains, assigned against my life, scatter in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth, open your mouth. We are not in this meeting to negotiate. We are not here for negotiation. We are here for serious action. Basanta Kaya Boshanta. Boraka Santaya Boshanta. Louder, 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 louder. In Jesus' name we pray. Wonderful. Now you have to be specific. Whatever you want to address, put it inside the prayer. You say, woe unto the mountain assigned against my career, assigned against my marriage, assigned against my calling. Put in what you want to put in now. Woe unto the mountain assigned against my calling in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth, open your mouth, open your mouth. Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Wonderful. This particular one now, you will say, wealth consuming mountains. Wealth consuming mountain. Hear the word of the Lord. Catch fire. Can I hear the sisters shouting it? Is that the loudest the sisters can say it? Brothers, let your voice be loud. Everybody together now. In the name of Jesus. Aha, 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 aha. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Right there where you are. Look at what is happening over there. That's right. The heavy load that the enemy has placed upon your head has come back to the senders. The arrows of wastage, the arrows of familiar spirits that has been troubling your destiny has come back to the senders. Stretch your right hand towards this altar now. Father, let your liquid fire and your power of deliverance, your power of healing, your power of breakthroughs fall upon these hands in the name of Jesus. Your word says, we shall lay our hands on the sick and the sick shall recover. Those hands that are stretching here, let it become an instrument of deliverance, instrument of healing, instrument of power, 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 in the name of Jesus. Lay that hand on any sick part of your body now and keep it there and let there be silence. You, the spirit of infirmity, that place you are is not your tabernacle. You have missed road. Right there where you are, with the spirit of infirmity, the visa that is keeping you in place, I cancel it now. In the name of Jesus. The voices in the ears, the heaviness at the back of the head, the cloudiness in the eyes, the palpitation of the heart, any strange swelling in any part of the body, any strange liquid coming out of the body, every strange pain in the body, I bind you and I cast you out. Every mountain of backwardness, we cast you into the sea now. The mountain of infirmity, we cast into the sea. 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 In the name of Jesus. Aha. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Any strange material that the enemy has passed into anybody's body, let this strange material be cancelled now. In the name of Jesus. I give you time to check your body now. Check it thoroughly. Do whatever you are not able to do before you got here. Any part of your body you cannot use, begin to use them now. The power of God is coming upon you and is working in every aspect of your body. Check it out, check it. That's right. Do what you cannot do. Thank you, Jesus. Once you've checked your body and you found that the healing power of God has touched you, what you could not do before you got here, you are not doing it. I don't want the enemy to put the problem back on you. Run quickly to the altar here and come and talk to us about it. The Bible said they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Find a way quickly to the altar here. Though you have been healed, God has touched you. Don't want the problem to come back. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Shout this now loud and clear. Visible and invisible mountain. On the way to my promised land. Scatter by fire. In the name of Jesus. Something is still happening here this morning. They send the lakarabo sepialekata. Receive the touch of the Almighty upon your body, upon your soul, upon your spirit. Receive the touch of the Almighty upon your body, upon your soul, upon your spirit. Receive the touch of the Almighty in the name of Jesus. Receive the touch of the Almighty in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Let there be silence now. I'm going to address some destroying mountains from the altar here. All I require from you is a resounding amen when I ask you to say it. Father, I pray for as many people as are here, and they or somebody they know is suffering from brain exchange. The enemy has exchanged the brain. Baseka pota likaribosanda. Receive your deliverance in the name of Jesus. Makatara basata. In the name of Jesus. I'm praying for anyone in this service. Right now there are strange poison in your body that the enemy has introduced into your body. Right there where you are, the power of God is coming upon you. The poison of darkness is coming out of your body now. Receive the touch of the power. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. I am praying for somebody here. You are fighting inherited warfare. This is strange. You have inherited a dark mountain which has been working against your wealth, working against your home, working against your destiny. Something is happening to you where you are. The fire of God, the wind of the Holy Ghost, the anointing of the Holy Ghost is falling upon you. And the yoke of the inherited warfare is broken now. Yes, that is the power of God coming upon you. That is the power of God coming upon you. That woman over there, hear the word of the Lord. Beginning from this morning, the powers of the night that have been coming to steal your baby from the womb, they have been buried alive. That is the power of God coming upon you too. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That's it. Touch it. That swelling in your womb, touch it. It has vanished. The swelling in the womb, the swelling in the womb has vanished. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. With a voice that is as loud as fire, you will shout this now loud and clear. Please make sure nobody's voice is louder than yours. Destroy mountains. Jesus' name we pray. I prophesy that this week shall be a week of blessing for you. The Lord will bless you from Zion and make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. Every prayer request here, answer the prayer request by fire. In the name of Jesus. The Almighty will arise for your sake. Almighty will disgrace your disgrace. You shall be a victor. Never a victim. Where the roads were closed before, the mountain moving Jesus shall shall clear the way for you in the name of Jesus. And all those who are in this service today, and the enemy has been challenging them, within the next 24 hours, let the powers responsible for the challenge be disgraced in the name of Jesus. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let us share the grace in fellowship. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow all the days of our life. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Seven miracle receiving, mountain destroying, hallelujah.